Hello everyone, I am Ruben Durant and I'm pleased to present our new weekly supervised technique for domain adaptation using Scribble. Traditional supervised learning approaches assume that the testing data from the target domain and the training data from the source domain are drawn from the same data distribution. However, in practice, this assumption doesn't always stand. For example, the training and the testing data may have been acquired with different acquisition protocols, leading to differences in resolution and visual appearance among these databases. Similarly, the two datasets may have been acquired with different clinical workflows, leading to the acquisition of different imaging modalities. Domain adaptation aims to bridge these distribution gaps to enhance generalization. Existing domain adaptation techniques can be divided into two groups, the semi-supervised and supervised approaches and the unsupervised ones. The supervised approaches require to annotate additional data from the target domain. In general, these techniques are easy to implement and stable during training. In contrast, unsupervised approaches do not require any additional annotations. While adversarial learning is the most common unsupervised approach, it has been mostly applied successfully to 2D cases and rely on a complex optimization procedure. In terms of accuracy, the supervised approaches are outperforming the unsupervised one. Indeed, it is dramatically easier to bridge the domain gap with additional annotations. However, given the time and expertise required to annotate this additional data, supervised techniques may not be an option in practice. So the question is, which option could we imagine to add some extra target information without requiring precise and time-consuming annotations? Our answer is weekly supervised learning. More precisely, we propose to use scribbles drawn on the target data, meaning some sparse annotation. Scribbles have many advantages. First, they provide precise location information without a precise delineation. Moreover, they allow covering complex shapes. And finally, as you can see on this video, scribbles are particularly user-friendly and quick to draw. While it will take around 15 to 20 minutes to annotate the scan, it only takes a minute to draw the scribbles. Now, let's present our model and firstly, its scribble supervision component. Given an image, we aim to perform an automatic segmentation using a standard neural network. We have access to some annotations, here the scribble. We could then minimize the discrepancy between the prediction and the annotations. However, this can only be done on a very small number of voxels. To include prior contextual information, we propose to use Markov random fields. This allows propagating the information from the annotated voxels to the non-annotated ones. Given an image, the optimization problem consists in minimizing a label assignment cost, composed of two terms. The unary term that corresponds to a cross-entropy and the pairwise term that encourages similar predictions to voxels that are similar. For this reason, this second term can be seen as a regularization term. Two voxels that are spatially close and with a similar image intensity are expected to be classified similarly. This is how we introduce some prior information. Here, the scribbles are used as a constraint on the final prediction. This graphical model is designed for the target images with the scribbles, but can also be applied for the source images, leading to the same optimization problem. However, for the source data, all the voxels are annotated. This leads to a simplification of the optimization problem, minimizing the cross-entropy between the network prediction and the ground truth. Thanks to this model, we allow propagating information within the image. However, we do not propagate information between the two domains. Inspired by co-segmentation, we propose to not only connect the voxels within the images, but also between the different images. Here, the similarity between two voxels is not spatial or related to the intensity value due to the domain gap, but related to the feature representation extracted from the neural network. Two voxels are likely to be similarly classified if they have a similar feature representation. Consequently, by minimizing this pairwise term, we encourage the network to learn a similar feature representation for two voxels associated to the same level but from two different domains. In other terms, this encourages the network to learn a domain invariant feature representation to perform domain adaptation. In the end, given two images, we aim to minimize the sum of the two image specific assignment costs and the domain adaptation regularization term. Instead of alternating the optimization with respect to the different variables such as in the CRF as RNN, we have shown that this optimization problem can be approximated using regularized loss. In practice, given two images from the source and the target domain, we generate predictions. On the source domain, we directly minimize the discrepancy between the ground truth and the prediction. On the target domain, we minimize this discrepancy on the voxels that are annotated. Additionally, we have an image-specific regularization term that aims to regularize the prediction within the image. Finally, a cross-domain regularization term propagates the information between the domains and encourages the network to learn a domain-invariant feature representation of the data. In fact, the only difference with a traditional supervised approach is these two regularization terms. These two terms are in fact easy to implement and our code is publicly available. To test our framework, we conducted experiments on segmenting vestibular schwannoma, a benign brain tumor. Accurate tumor segmentation and volumetric measurements have been shown to be the best indicators to detect subtle vestibular schwannoma growth. In practice, the segmentation can be either done on the contrast-enhanced T1 scans or on the T2 scans. In this work, we tested our model on a cross-modality problem. The source data corresponds to contrast-enhanced T1 scans and the target data corresponds to T2 scans. Importantly, only 30 T2 scans have been annotated using scribbles. On average, 1% of the T2 scan and 7% of the tumor have been annotated. This dataset will be publicly available soon, and I will also release the scribbles. Our experiments include a comparison with the state-of-the-art unsupervised domain adaptation techniques using adversarial learning and specifically designed for cross-modality domain adaptation, and an ablation study to isolate the contribution of each component of a framework. Firstly, as a sanity check, we can see that introducing the different regularization term doesn't degrade the performance on the source domain. Secondly, we found that the existing unsupervised techniques are dramatically failing on the target domain, highlighting the need for supervision. This can be due to the fact that the problem is too challenging for unsupervised domain adaptation, given that the tumor appearance varies greatly between the T2 and the T1 scans. Additionally, the ablation study showed that our main contribution, the DA regularization term, brings significant improvement. Finally, we observed that our model surprisingly outperformed the fully supervised approach trained on the 30 fully annotated scans. This suggests the benefit of leveraging the source annotated data. The same conclusion can be drawn qualitatively. On this figure, the contours of the ground truth masks are shown in yellow while the predictions are in green. Firstly, we observe that without domain adaptation, the network fails in detecting the tumor. Secondly, adversarial techniques are not able to localize precisely the tumor. Finally, we can see that our model achieves comparable performance to a fully supervised model. To summarize, in this work we proposed a new weakly supervised domain adaptation technique using Scribbles. This technique is an efficient and pragmatic reply to the need for supervision for challenging domain adaptation problems. Experiments have demonstrated that our approach outperforms unsupervised domain adaptation and achieves comparable performance to a fully supervised approach trained on a few samples. Thank you a lot for your attention, and I hope that you will join on Monday. Bye.